y'all can do better than that. Good evening. Thank y'all for having us here today. This is extremely important, and certainly it's important for you to get to know your candidates, particularly in this race. I suspect there aren't very many of you who live in the 1st District. If you live in the 1st District, will you raise your hand? We've got a couple of people. That's good. Thank y'all for being here. As you know, we've been served for the last 22 years by Jack Kingston. He's done a wonderful job, a great job, and those are big shoes to fill. I am Buddy Carter, and I'm from Pooler, Georgia. Anybody know where Pooler is? You know, Savannah's a suburb of Pooler. I guess Pooler's a suburb of Savannah. Nevertheless, we left Pooler this morning at about 9:30, and we got here at about, 5:30. Now, we made some stops along the way, but it does take quite a while to get from one end of the district to the other end. It kind of reminded me of a story, not a story, but an experience I have. My wife and I are blessed with 3 sons, and when the 2 oldest sons were small, we took them on that trip to Disney World. You know, that's the trip you always take, and the kids are so excited. Well, from Pooler to Orlando, it's a good 5.5 hours. And I'll be quite honest with you, I was excited about the trip, but I was not excited about the car ride, not at all, because I knew what was going to happen. And sure enough, it happened. It happened just as soon as we got out of the driveway. 2 little guys were in the back seat, and it started. Daddy, are we there yet? Daddy, are we there yet? Well, I knew I couldn't take that for 5 or 5.5 hours. So I stopped the car, and I turned around, and I said, look, guys, I don't want to hear it anymore. I don't want to hear, Daddy, are we there yet, anymore on this trip. I turned around, I started driving. My wife, she looked over at me and gave me one of those looks that said, you have just ruined the whole trip for everybody. And I was feeling kind of bad. My oldest son, he was about 6 years old at that time. He finally chimed up a little bit later on, and he said, Daddy, can I ask you something? And I said, sure, son, what is it? He said, Daddy, when we get there, will I still be 6 years old? So I didn't really think we were ever going to get here today, but we did get here, and it's a pleasure to be here. And again, thank you for having us, because this is important. This is an important race, an important decision to be made on who's going to succeed Jack Kingston and serve us in the United States Congress. As you know, we've got a number of issues facing us here in this nation. I've had the good fortune of serving as mayor of the city of Pooler. I was mayor of Pooler for 9 years. I've served in the State House along with Representative Ellis Black. I served there for 5 years, and then I graduated to the upper chamber in the state senate, where I've been there and serving with Senator Tim Golden for the last 5 years. So about 22 years of experience in public service, and I tell you that to tell you that I started when I was 10 years old. But anyway, I have been doing it for a while, and it's indeed an honor to be the Republican nominee for Congress. Folks, as I said, our nation has a number of issues, a number of challenges. These are trying times in our country. Very quickly, I want to go over 4 things that are very important to me. A number of things are important. These 4 are what I base my platform on. First of all, our national debt. Secondly, job creation. Thirdly is our military. And 4th is health care. Now, let's start with our national debt. $18 trillion in debt. $18 trillion. Folks, I've lived the American dream. I grew up in Fort Wilmington, Georgia. My daddy worked in the paper mill. He worked shift work. He worked hard. He provided for my sister and I, for our family. I was the first one in my family to graduate from college. I opened my own business. I've had my own business for 26 years. I've lived the American dream. Unless we change the direction of our country now, our children and our grandchildren aren't going to have that opportunity to live the American dream. I do not want it to be the legacy of my generation to leave to future generations $18 trillion in debt. We can do better than that. The first thing that we have to do is to balance our budget. You know, Congress, who was out for 6 weeks, and then they came back in for 2 weeks, and what did they do during that 2-week period in September? Passed a continuing resolution, just to continue on. They don't even pass a budget. Now, Representative Black will tell you, in the state of Georgia, we have to balance our budget. According to our Constitution, we have to do that. Now, how are we going to balance our budget? How are we going to retire this national debt? Well, we have to do 3 things. First of all, we've got to cut expenses. We know that. Secondly, we've got to have entitlement reform. Thirdly, and most importantly, we've got to grow our way out of it. I heard someone mention just a minute ago about the expected growth of Lowndes County in the future. That's what we've got to have. We've got to have growth. We simply can't do it by having entitlement reform and by cutting expenses along. It has to be more. The second thing I want to talk about is job creation. Now, please understand that I do not believe that government creates jobs. However, I do believe that government can create an environment in which jobs can be created. Look at the city of Pooler. Look where I was mayor. I became mayor in 1996. Our population was 4,500. When I left in 2004, our population was 19,000. Now that was a lot of new rooftops. Some of it was annexation, but most of it was new rooftops. That's the kind of growth that we have to have. That was creating jobs. We've had commercial development, industrial development. That's how you create jobs. That's how government creates jobs. Third is our military. Hear me and hear me clearly. The number one responsibility of our federal government is to provide for the safety of our citizens. We can only do that through a strong military. We are fortunate in 1st District. We are blessed to have four military installations. We have Hunter Army Airfield. We have Fort Stewart. We have Kings Bay. And yes, as you well know, we have Moody Air Force Base. And we have to take care of those bases. They contribute to the military might of our nation. They're important to the military might of our nation. We've got to make sure we keep those in place, and I commit to you that I will do my very best to do that. Fourth and finally is something I have some experience with. I am a pharmacist and have been practicing for over 34 years. And yes, I began when I was 10 years old, again, practicing pharmacy. I'm just kidding. But I have been practicing for 34 years, and I know something about health care. I've had my own business for 26 years, and let me tell you, Obamacare has been a disaster thus far. The rollout of Obamacare has been horrible. It's been a disaster. I believe in free market principles, free market solutions. Let us compete. Let me ask you something. How many of you have gone to your drugstore only to be told that we would have, before we can fill that prescription on your insurance, we've got to call the insurance company and find out if they'll cover it? You had that experience to get a prior approval? Drug therapy is not being decided by your doctor. It's not being decided by your pharmacist. It's not being decided by you. It's being decided by your insurance company. And folks, that's not right. You should have, along with your doctor, along with your pharmacist, you should have a say in what you're going to be taking. Those are the kind of solutions that we need in healthcare. We need free market solutions. Remember what happened when Walmart decided they wanted to be a player in the pharmacy business? They went to a $4 prescription. I was competing at that time. I said, no way I'm going to do that. I bowed my back. I said, nuh-uh, I'm not going to sell generic prescriptions for $4. 2 weeks later, I was selling generic prescriptions for $4. That's what competition does in healthcare, and that's what we need in healthcare, more competition. So those four things are very important to me. The national debt and balancing our budget, job creation, a strong military, and then health care. I want to thank you again for having us here tonight. It's an honor to be with you. This is an important election, and I know that many of you don't live in the 1st Congressional District. You live in another district. But you know people who do live in Eccles County and the Moody Air Force Base area. You know people who live in Clinch County and all the other 17 counties that are in the 1st District. I ask you tonight for your support. I ask you tonight for your prayers, and I ask you for your vote. Thank you very much for having us here tonight.